What Franklin saw as the electric atmosphere is seen in modern terms as the electric field. An electric field is present around any object that carries a net electric charge. Of course, if an object's positive charge and negative charge are balanced, the object is electrically neutral, and it produces virtually no electric field far away. But even beyond that, the static electric field inside any piece of metal is zero, which means a test charge would feel no force at all inside the piece of metal. And that's true even if the metal has a net electric charge. That's because the charge piles up on the surface until there's no field left inside to make it move. Of course, electrically charged conductors do create electric fields outside themselves. But inside, there's no field at all. And because there's an electric field between two oppositely charged pieces of metal, there's bound to be a difference in potential between them. But since there's no field inside, the potential is the same everywhere in the metal. So, each piece of metal is a region of constant potential. The potential difference between two pieces of metal depends on how much net charge each one has. Negative charge lowers the potential. And positive charge raises the potential. Of course, in the 1700s, Dr. Franklin was in no position to get such a clear picture of